is a very serious musician. His latest album is at number 10 in the album charts, which is great. He loves his music, and so apparently does the Queen. The star of the recent Royal Variety performance, will you welcome Mr. Freddie Starr? Under your control, you see. Does he look splendid, don't you think?
Yes!
I can't believe that they finally plucked up courage to let you back in the Royal Variety.
Yes, that's what I thought.
Was it after something like 20 years?
It was when I got divorced from Frank Bruno. I did the last Royal Command show because Frank used to be my wife. And he was a very nice man to me. Very kind to me.
Did you enjoy doing the Royal Variety? Because you really did emerge the star, didn't you?
Sorry, I'm a bit deaf. Sorry. Speaking to this.
Microphone.
There's a microphone inside this.
Can you watch my lips?
Yeah, I'd like to kiss them.
You ready? Right? Oh, right. I was saying, you emerged the star of the Royal Variety.
You're beautiful. You're so beautiful. Oh, God. You're beautiful. Look at him, too. Swiss match of him.
Be Frank Bruno to lift up that vase vase of yours.
Pardon?
Oh, nothing, forget
you that. You said you got to beat Frank Bruno to pick up that vase vase of yours.
What's a vase vase of yours?
Oh, vase vase of yours.
One of those.
I didn't know he spoke French. And oh, vase vase of yours.
But actually, think about your singing career and the fact that you started off in Liverpool. You just might have been a Beatle, because you were sort of around at that time, weren't
yes,
you?
Yes, very much so. We used to go, Jerry and the Pacemakers, the Beatles, all the groups, Billy J. Kramer. We all used to meet in this place called The Grape. And we used to sit around, John Lennon and everybody, and we used to do shows together. We used to go to New Brighton and do shows together and that. And we were all pals. It was just... I never once thought the Beatles would ever make it.
Why, you didn't think they were any good at the time?
It wasn't a case of that. It's because once you... It's the pals, you know, I mean, you know them, you know. All right, Paul, if you're watching. All right, Paul. That's for Paul McCartney. Anyway, and it was a very exciting time. And when Bob Wooler, a guy called Bob Wooler, that used to be the disc jockey down at the cabin, played me the record, I said, come on, give me a break. Because at the time it was all Little Richard and Eddie Cochran and them sort of people that were really hitting the charts. And when I heard their music, I went, oh, come on, you can't be serious. Like they think about my record. You know, you can't be serious. And I'm not.
Some people used to think that you were Ringo Starr's brother.
Yeah, I was married to Ringo. He had my child, and he was just very difficult to live with, and I'm not going to expose him. But before Tom Jones had the nose job done, him and Ringo used to stand back to back, and they used to look like a pickaxe. And oh, poor Ringo. They hooted on that, eh? Hey, where are you going? Sorry, pal.
Now, listen, let me just ask you, though, about Elvis, because allegedly you really did love him. I mean...
Oh, he was a lovely person, a nice guy. And he had this charisma about him. That was... I can't explain. Only in spiritual terms, he had this aura around him. And he was such a professional, you know, and such a nice guy. And his performance was absolutely fantastic. There's no other word for it. And I'm glad that I was alive at the same time as he was on this planet, if you know what I mean.
That's pretty profound.
Yeah, because my little daughter will miss out on that. She'll never know who Elvis Presley was. She'll never sort of wake up and go, since my baby left me.
Hey, that might be a cue for song, because you've got a few Elvis tracks on the album, so what are you going to sing?
This song is called Don't Go Down the Mines, Daddy, there's bags of slack in your pants.
Tell you what, audience, why don't you give him a bit of encouragement and then he'll sing for you.
Thank you. Yeah.
Myself, I can't deceive. I know it's only make believe. My one and only prayer is that someday you care. My hopes and my dreams come true. My one and only.
Pretty safely anyway. That's about it for this week.
We
will see you in a fortnight's time. Yes, we will. It'll be a very special Christmas Eve.
Christmas Eve. Special Christmas Eve on Sunday.
Who will it feature?
I think it's Coronation Street, somebody from Coronation Street.
That's right, Barbara, what's her name? Barbara Knox, actually, who played
Yes,
the fairy
Barbara
club,
Knox.
Yes?
Yeah, yeah.
And Cliff Richard's going to be here.
Oh, Cliff! I like Cliff!
Yeah. Hi, Cliff! And Jason Donovan will be here as well.
Oh, Jason! Jason!